received a couple photographs from a friend of a plant they didn't recognize. And it's from a slope just north of Leavenworth, Washington. Saw it in the field, and the minute I saw it in the field, I thought, oh yeah, I think we got something new here. I think this is something new to science. So I came back here to the herbarium where I also work and looked at collections that we had filed under a different species name and was pleasantly surprised that it actually had been collected before. It was first collected on May 1st of 1989, and the person who collected it recognized that it was something different and left a little annotation tag on the collection here that suggested that it was something that needed to be followed up on, but nobody had followed up on it. So we had the yellow flowers versus purple flowers. We had cuspidate leaves versus non-cuspidate leaves. The fruit on the new species is considerably larger. The plant is larger. It's up to 3 feet tall. So it's pretty clear they're worthy of being called two different species. So I've been working intensively in this genus anyway. To have the opportunity to work with a new species is always an honor and a pretty cool thing. But my guess is that this entire species with all the individuals is probably comprised of less than 1,000 plants. So that's an extremely rare plant. Starting to jump aboard a new trend, which is to auction off the naming rights associated with a little environmental educational organization called the Wild Society that expressed some interest in seeing if maybe they could get in on auctioning one of these names off and have that be a fundraiser for this nonprofit. And the folks that do describe new species tend to be folks who are on the periphery of academia, such as myself. And finding ways to fund what we do is not easy, and this seems to be an interesting option to do. Finding these plants now, getting them described, getting them on the radar screen, may assist down the road in getting these things to survive longer term than they perhaps would otherwise.